Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and the Android 11 March 2021 security update is now rolling out to Pixel devices and soon to other devices. Now, you may already have it if you have something like a Note 20 Ultra, for example, or maybe a few days later or a few weeks later. That's up to the manufacturer, but it's currently out for supported Pixel devices, and you should be getting it soon if you haven't already. And that means it supports the Pixel 3, 3 XL, 3A, 3A XL, 4, 4 XL, 4A, and 4A 5G, and Pixel 5 that I have here. And so this particular update brings a bunch of security updates, as well as this year's first Pixel feature drop. And so let's take a look at the build number, then we'll talk about what's new. And as you can see here, it says your system is up to date, and it's got the March 5th, 2021 update, even though it's not March 5th yet. So let's take a look at the build number, and you can see here as it scrolls by, it says 11RQ2A.210305.006. And this particular update, like I said, brings security and more, but let's first talk about the new features. And the first thing is voice recognition. If you're using Gboard to use it for text, if that's your main keyboard, you'll have some updates coming soon if you don't have them already. So if we go into, say, Docs, for example, and in Google Docs, if you use the microphone button, you'll have some better voice recognition and enhanced voice recognition and better understanding, and you can send commands such as clear to clear things off. Now, mine is not showing up yet. Normally, you'll have a bar at the bottom that shows like the Google Assistant. Even though I have the newest update, it's not showing, but you can tell that with the little bar that's showing up. And then I could say things like the word clear, for example, and it would go back and clear things out. For whatever reason, it's not on my Pixel device, but they do roll these out slowly. Unfortunately, this feature is only available for the Pixel 4 series, 4A, 4A 5G, and Pixel 5. So that feature is not available for anything else. But you'll see it's keeping up nicely, but it doesn't have the enhanced features just yet, unfortunately. So hopefully I'll see that soon. Not everyone is seeing it just yet. Now, to go along with that, if you use Google Recorder, for example, let's find that here. In Google Recorder, you can back up your data, and you'll back up automatically. If you have recordings, you can keep it offline, but I want to back it up. It will back up to Google Drive. And the new thing here is if I record a voice text memo or whatever we're recording now, you can now see these online after you're done using this. So it's similar to what we had before, where we can access all of our different voice recordings, but now we'll be able to not only access the audio, we can access the transcript online. And so I'll pause this here, and I won't add a location, and then I'll just save it as Pixel feature drop. There we go. I'll hit save, and then it will save online, and I'll be able to see it at recorder.google.com, as you can see here. So if we go there, we'll wait for it to load, and you can watch this. We'll just go to my recordings here. And now you can see my recordings at the website here. So recorder.google.com, you'll be able to access this anywhere you have access to the internet. And you can go to your Pixel feature drop, and the transcript is there as well, although it's kind of overlapping here, but you get the idea. So it's there, which is nice, and that's a slight update to this. Now, another thing they've updated is Smart Compose. Smart Compose has been around for a while in Google Docs and Gmail, but the feature has been updated and will support more apps in the future. Now, this works really well. If you've ever used it, we'll go into Gmail so I can show you. And maybe you want to email someone. I can say, hi, how are you today? And it finishes it for me. I can just swipe and it finishes the sentence. It works really well and it works online and everywhere else, but they're bringing it to more apps. The unfortunate thing is this is only available to devices in the United States on Pixel devices only and only in English for now. So hopefully they'll update that in the future. Now, the next thing has to do with Google Fit. If you're using Google Fit, there'll be some additional features soon. Now, I'm not seeing these yet, unfortunately, but one of them is you can now measure your heart rate when you go into Google Fit, and it will use your camera to measure your heart rate, similar to what older Samsung devices did, where you would put your finger over an optical sensor, it would measure your heart rate that way, and it will also measure your breathing as well using the forward-facing camera and some technology where it can see your chest move and sense your breathing. So those things are being added with the Google Fit update. Again, I'm not seeing this, but it is rolling out soon. So if you're not seeing it, give it a few days, maybe a week or so, and it will roll out to everyone else. Now there's some new wallpapers as well. So if we go into our wallpapers here, we'll press and hold on the home screen, go to styles and wallpapers, scroll down, and you'll see it says curated culture. Now there's 6 new wallpapers, and this is for International Women's Day 2021 and Women's History Month. And so there's some different ones by artists here. You can see there's one, here's the next one, and there's quite a few. So you can pick from any of these 6 here. You want new wallpaper. Of course, I know a lot of people are always asking for my wallpaper, which I always link in the description. But as you can see, there's some new ones here for Women's History Month as well. Now, if you have a Google Pixel stand, there's an additional feature that will help you when you go to sleep with some new visualizations. So let me see if I can turn on bedtime mode and get it to come up. I wasn't able to get it to come up earlier today, and let's see if I can get that to activate. You can see my device is now black and white, and that's to sort of discourage you from using it to help you go to sleep. So we'll put it on the Pixel stand, and you'll see it's charging, and we'll see if we get any different visualizations. And nothing new yet. Now, again, this is supposed to be rolling out with the feature drop soon. I'm not seeing many of the feature drop changes, so we should be seeing more soon, but right now I'm not seeing anything. Now, finally, there's some updates to the camera that will allow you to take underwater pictures if you have a Kraken Sports smartphone mount. So if you have one of those for the Pixel 5, you can use the camera now underwater, and it will help you take better photos with things like night sight and portrait mode and more. So that's pretty interesting. They're bringing that to underwater photography now as well. So that's it for the features, but there's some bug fixes and improvements as well in this particular update. So for example, for apps on all of the supported Pixel devices, there's a fix for an issue causing Android Auto to disconnect in certain scenarios. Android Auto should now be working properly and stopped its disconnecting issues that it was having. Also, there's some display and graphics fixes for the Pixel 4a, 4a 5G, and Pixel 5, and that fixes an issue that caused full screen displays to appear chopped in certain use cases. So if you were having issues maybe tearing on the screen, those things should be fixed now as well. There's also a fix for issues preventing the auto rotate when you're using your phone and you have auto rotate activated. That should be fixed as well, but that's only on the Pixel 4a 5G and Pixel 5. Also, there's a fix for issues causing the battery indicator percentage to get stuck. So maybe your battery isn't showing the proper percentage. That should be fixed as well. And again, that's actually on the Pixel 4a 5G and Pixel 5 only. Now, there's a few kernel updates to all of the phones as well, so they all get a kernel update, whether that be for security or other fixes as well, just to make it seem more responsive. That's basically the main underlying part of the operating system, so that's been updated. Now, within the system interface, there's a new fix for issues preventing the heads-up notification for starred contacts when you're using Do Not Disturb. So that's been fixed in all Pixel-supported devices. And then finally, on the Pixel 4a 5G and Pixel 5, there's a fix to prevent missed call notifications in certain scenarios. They haven't stated what those scenarios are, but if you were missing your calls, hopefully they'll be coming through properly now. Now, there's additional security patches in this update as well. So there is 1 Android runtime patch, 8 framework patches, 5 media framework patches, 18 system updates, 1 Google Play system update, 20 kernel updates, 5 Qualcomm component updates, and 23 Qualcomm closed source component updates. So a lot of security updates in this particular version, and I would highly recommend that you install it if you haven't already. These feature drops are really nice. Unfortunately, they sort of roll out slowly, and I'm not seeing them all yet, but we should have them fairly soon. The nice thing is, so far, in using it for the past hour or two, I've actually seen no slowdowns whatsoever after it finished installing all the application updates and things like that. Everything is nice and fast. Everything's responding like you would expect, and I haven't had any issues there whatsoever. The other thing as well is battery has been great on this phone. I've been using it for quite some time, and I've never had any issues. It will stay really dormant for quite some time without draining the battery all the way down. Days, for example, it has great standby. So no issues there, and I'm pretty happy with the Pixel 5 overall. So if you found anything else, though, let me know in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper, like I said earlier, in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already, though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.